Hi guys, this is Jess, and I'm going to give you guys the full June 2018 reading. For those of you who are interested in the extended portion of this reading, all you have to do is click the link below in the description box, and it'll take you straight there. And you can look and see what else is in store for you guys for the remainder of June. So if you're interested, yeah, click that link below and we can get started. Otherwise, on with your reading. Take care, guys. Libra, this is Jess with your June 2018 reading. I hope you guys are having an enjoyable day so far. So, Libra, in the past, I see that some of you were happy about results that were coming about, movements forward. You were taking some movements forward. I feel uncharted territory, new movements forward. You may have even heard that someone's coming toward you, but it's a process. Like someone will be moving. Someone's going to be moving where you live. Someone's going to be coming to see you. An opportunity is going to be coming your way, but it is a process. It may not be completely realized until we get further down the line, but it is a step in the right direction for some of you Libras in past energy, and it's made you very happy. I do see at this time some of you are in your true Libra energy. You're a little stuck. You're needing to make a decision, but you're not able to. And you've been trying to wait for a sign, wait for some news, wait for some money that's going to be able to be the money coming in, a specific amount of money. If you're waiting for money, that will change the game for you. Some of you may be waiting on a person to change the game for you. There's a waiting. If it's not a person, it's money. If it's not money, it's a circumstance that lies on you. You need to make the decision in so that you can make the move forward. And in that comes this new situation that comes about. Some of you, again, like I said, you've been waiting, trying to figure out what this thing, how this thing is going to all come about. When is it going to happen? And I feel like you've gotten your calm. You've gone from feeling stuck to analyzing, waiting, investing, to now feeling a sense of calm, to now feeling like, okay, I know it's coming. I just need to wait now. And it may be within the next like two, you know, this may go on as far as like you feeling calm, you feeling a sense of patience for the next couple of weeks or so. Drinking a lot of water, eating healthy, eating foods that are alive and that sort of thing of the earth will help promote this energy more for you guys that are feeling a bit anxious and stuck. For those of you who are saying, I'm not there yet, well, drinking a lot of water and eating more pure foods will get you there, and it'll keep that energy around a lot longer. I do see that there's a wanting to kind of also come together. If there's, like I said, a time apart from a situation or a particular person. Now, some of you have been working really hard, a lot of work you've taken on, or a lot of burden, a lot of responsibility you've been taking on lately. And there's not been any playtime. You haven't been able to get out and just socialize. You haven't seen your friends in a long time. You've not been able to engage like you want to. There's just been a lot of burden, and this burden you feel completely controlled by, because you can't make a move forward. I guess some of you feel stuck. I get this more predominant for Libra women, that you feel completely stuck. If you live with your mother, there may be a problematic situation. I see woman, either immature male or child, male child. If you have a daughter, talk to her. And I mean, if you have a little daughter, especially a one that's newly developing, like she may start to get a period. She may start to get breasts. It's something about a little girl's hormones that is affecting her, I feel. That you need to address. Something could be going on with one of your daughters that she's too scared. She's completely frightened to tell you. So that's a head up for those of you out there. If it's something that you like to share, and you feel so comfortable in the comment section below, you're more than welcome to use that forum, or you're even more than welcome to use my email if you'd like to you know, share anything or to confirm this. But I do see like some of you need to check up with your daughter, because there's some There's something going on with your daughter. You'll realize that when you see her, and it's something with her reproductive system or her breasts. She's just newly gotten hormones or something like that. If you're sharing the home with unfamiliar people, or she's just been acting different, definitely you've got to probe. You Libra woman, if this is you though, if you felt like you've been controlled and reduced down to, to just this, minimum miniature size of yourself, that's changing. That's changing. And you are completely standing in your own right. You're very confident. I almost get the same energy that I got for Cancer and Taurus women. Cancer and Taurus women are forces to be reckoned with right now. And I feel that Libra women are kind of standing back in their truth, especially if you have fire in your chart. If you have fire energy, Leo, Sagittarius, or Aries. Now, you may be dealing with this. You may be having to address someone who feels as though they are controlling you. They deserve to control you. If you are the female aspect here, then they could be a man, a immature man, or you may have some issue with your teenage son or your younger son being combative against you. I don't feel like they're going to be very successful. I don't care what age they're in. But someone came to you, and this is past energy, right? So sometime in May, coming into June, someone challenged you or was questioning you and thought that they, thought it was going to work. And they quickly realized that, yeah, she woke up. Like, she woke up out of this haze of feeling as though she was in despair. Like, some of you've woken up. Now, I get this having had to have gone through this deep inner solace, and it's like internal transformation. You could not find the answers. You couldn't get complete enlightenment until you went within, until you got still, until you were quiet. You may be even dealing with a Virgo. If that's the case, they'll be doing this to you. They're doing this because they're completely confused. There's two things that weighs heavy on their heart. They are not sure with one. They feel like it's going to, diminish right before their eyes, and something else has more of see how my voice is starting to completely leave me? That's how I feel like someone in your personal life, child, mate, mother, they something heavy is going on with them. And it's as if when they try to open their mouth, nothing can come out. If they start to say one word, they can't even get the full sentence out because they'll go mute. So it would behoove you, Libras, step back, watch people, give people their space, try to come from a place of comfort and love. I feel like you're very dominating right now, Libra women, and Libra men are very combative right now. And I feel the best way to handle this is to be light-handed and open-hearted, because I just feel people around you. You're not paying attention that something is going on with the people around you. Now, this could be going on with Libras, but the reason why I say it's you being a little bit less comforting is because your energy is the Page of Swords and the Knight of Swords. So that's going from being very investigative, questioning, combative, asking a bunch of questions, needing answers, probing. But that's someone that could have been doing it to you. And then I see there being this conflict that comes out of someone's reaction or lack of engagement with you, or acting as if they don't know what to do. So someone is impatient about someone's slower steps. Someone is impatient and being combative about someone's slower pace toward a resolve or truth being told. Okay, so hopefully that's not you being combative about the situation, because whoever is taking their time, they really do need to, because they're confused or the situation really has a hold on them and it's pretty deep. Now, external to you, if this is a work situation, I usually focus on work, but this particular theme is pretty heavy. If this is a work situation, I feel like you guys were probably waiting on money, waiting on a movement forward. If you were contractually, you probably trying to see if you can get into another job, if they're going to hire you on. I feel for now you're kind of safe if you work contractual, if you have your own business. There's going to be good flow of income coming in, like a lot of clients, like steady. I don't feel like it'll be ridiculously high. At times it may, like one day it will be higher than the other, but it'll be a steady flow of money and clients coming in. Steady flow, steady flow. You'll have clients that want to ask a lot of questions. They want to talk a lot, probably more than normal. People that feel like they want your time. Be very careful with time management because you can easily trip up one appointment with the other. You may find it very difficult to steal away time for yourself because as soon as you're trying to correct one thing, someone's coming in, they need help with this, they need that. And you have to go after and address people as well. So if there's things that you need to stay on top of with people, if there's something you need to handle in like your own personal business, you're gonna have to stay on top of people because a lot of people are checking out. Now, but try to do it with a soft hand, okay? Now, external to you, I feel that there is this sense of some people are moving forward in a new sort of way. If you're looking for a job, some of you may be trying to follow up on old jobs, and you need to be looking forward because there's new opportunities moving forward in places that could be unknown or foreign to you. There is a new movement forward if you have a job. They're coming up with some kind of new way of doing things. They may be implementing something new, which is going to kind of make some shifts and changes. They could be looking further ahead and making, do I see cuts here? Yeah, if you have an hourly job, your wages could go down a bit. Okay, and there may be a cut, but that comes down the line. But I see some shifts and changes, okay, which is coming down the line. They're developing it now. So there's some developmental changes happening at the workplace. If you're looking for work, I feel like you could possibly see something down the line. Not right this second, not in the energy that we're in right now. The second week, for those of you in a work sphere, there's going to be some news comes down from higher ups, okay? It can be via company letter. It can be a blast email, but it'll be something that everyone has to pay attention to, take note of. And there's this new way. I keep getting new way. They're implementing it now, but possibly by the second week of June, you'll get the news of a new way that they've created a new department. They're developing a new store. They have this new thing. Something new is about to happen, and they're going to be hiring people. So you'll have an opportunity to go into this new place, move to this new place, go to this new location, apply to this completely new opportunity with this new department that they're creating. You may even hear from someone that you know that, hey, such and such is hiring. If you hear that, definitely put your resume in because you'll hear quickly, you'll get an invitation for interview very quickly. So some news is coming in that's going to allow you to start moving forward in a new stage of your life, which is literally going to be like this, like I'm talking about completely new. Okay, let me calm down because I'm getting excited. Calm down. There's going to be some new things that is happening for Libras, ones that you can't see. So basically, going into your second week is like a huge change is going to start coming up. For some of you, you'll be able to move around in your job. Others of you, you'll get a new opportunity. If you're looking for work, the second week of June would be that time that things will start to shift and move for you. Okay. Now, I must say that although there's like, I get light and dark energy, I get like yin and yang, good and bad, that sort of thing. There's a lot of like Libras, you gotta bring it down. You've got to bring it down. I feel like you guys are like, you're like a bubbling pot, a bubbling pot. And as long as you sit there, you're not sure and you don't know, you're just simmering. You're just there. And then any little thing can take you off. Any little thing can set you off. And you go off on these tangents and you yelling and scream and you go off and then you back down to a simmer. You back down to a boil. But what you don't understand is that the people around you are very sensitive and you're affecting them. You really are. Your words are very biting. It's like intimidating to some extent. So you've got to be careful with what you're saying or how you're saying something. Okay. I feel like you're being very demanding, some of you as well. And this is for both men and women. You're being very demanding. So try to channel that energy. Now, Mars is trining a lot of you, so you have all of this nervous energy and a lot going on, and you could easily become combative, which is what I'm seeing here. The best way to remedy that situation is to go to the gym, is to be out, to physically, but not be out drinking and eating and all of that. Go out and do something where your body is getting physically exhausted. That's going to bring your mind back to a level of normal, and you won't feel this burst of like, I'm going to explode, because that's what I see, okay? I do see like an out of the blues, an explosion happening that does not necessarily need to happen if you would use other ways to exert this energy. So just be mindful of that. Now, and that's the advice. I don't see it actually factually happening, but that is the advice. So I do see sparks of it having happened in your present energy. Like I said, the second week looks far more positive for you guys, and you'll be then settled in. There's a move. Some people are moving. Some of you are moving. You are making a decision to move and leave this job. Some of you are planning a trip. Some of you have now gotten it. Okay. Yes, you can get this job. Yes, you can. Or we're interested in you. There's like, we're interested. So the second week is an we're interested in you. Yes, you can come interview. We want you. This is opened up, and it's going to be at a distance from some of you. It's going to be away from where you're living now. Okay. And I have to tell you, the third and fourth week, you have got to hold on to your seatbelts. It's like some Libras know that they're in a new stage of their life. They're moving forward in something new. You're just at this place right now. You don't know what the hell is going to be for some of you, or how you're going to get there if you know what it is. It also, for some of you, is contingent on another person. And once all of this comes into play, you guys really don't understand to the level of how change is going to come upon you. Like, you guys are in for a huge change that's about to come, which is very evident in the third and fourth week in this spread. Now let's go into love. In the past, I feel like some of you were happy that you were moving forward in a situation and almost had new breath in it. If it was an existing relationship, or you could have kind of became really close with a friend, someone that, you know, you liked them, they showed that they probably liked you, but it was just like, you're moving slow, you know, no one's taking it too fast. And it kind of stopped. You kind of got to a point where you're like, I don't know if I want to get into this. This person may have echoed the same sentiments that they're trying to figure out if this is something that they want. If you're a new person in their life, they still have somebody from their past that they have to deal with, that they have to take care of completely. It's unfinished. They have a lot going on, especially if you're dealing with a Virgo. And Virgos are so aware of this that they're taking a step all the way back. I feel like some of you may be kind of speaking again with each other. If there's been like this problematic situation, or each person going to their own corners, you'll speak again. You may have already started speaking, or you will be, you know, before this week is out, you guys will probably start speaking again. And there's been a lot, some of you, because you haven't been speaking to someone, you've been really focusing on work. They've been focusing on work. You've not been able, getting together again, communicating, talking, but there's not been this time to kind of just be able to get together. Okay. And you're not friendly. You haven't been friendly to each other either. Out of some form of coming together, there may be some talks about, now if this is an actual relationship, I'll speak to it in an actual one-to-one relationship. You guys, if you've been not speaking for some time, you're going to come together again. There's going to be either talking about, oh, well, I'm still going to read it this way. Talking about something a little bit concrete. There may be something about money, practical things, but you'll be nice to each other. Be very nice talking to each other. And I feel like in the past, this relationship, the feminine aspect here, the Libra woman, or the woman in the relationship, Libra man, she felt stifled. She felt controlled. She felt as if there was, she felt stifled, controlled, minimized. And she's coming out of that, especially if that's a fire sign. If you're dealing with, or have been dealing with a fire sign, she has fire in her chart. She's coming out of that. Okay. You, Libra man, or the male aspect here, may have tried to argue, confront. That didn't go very well. Some of you. Okay, so I'll just leave it at that. The one-to-one relationships, the one-to-one relationships. So there's a change in dynamic of this particular relationship. There may have been a distance here, trying to sift through if you should start anew. There could even be somebody from your past that you reminisce about, that you think about. Be careful, because you may be calling this person and this person will come out of nowhere just wanting to talk to you. You may have already heard from this person. I get every time that you may want to be to yourself or by yourself, this person has made attempts to contact you. If you're in this one-to-one relationship and you guys have been in this stage of not speaking, they've tried to, but you just see them as immature, and as confrontational. Okay. Someone is seeing the other person as immature and or confrontational. Okay. Now, your mate external to you, I feel that they have something completely new going on. They are focusing on life in front of them. They will be manifesting the things that they put their mind to. A lot of things are going to start to develop for them and fast. Okay. You'll start seeing, yes, for them, they're going to probably put you behind them and they're going to move forward very quickly. If you are a Libra man, okay, you may feel as though you're perceived this way, and someone may say, like, you never loved me, you didn't have feelings for me, but they don't understand the pain that was caused. They don't understand how much you've changed. Like, you're not the same man anymore because of that pain that you had to come on the other side of. You're now more self-controlled, rigid. You don't let people in. You still up very easily. It's hard to get to your heart these days. So you have changed, and it has a lot to do with the fact that you love this person. But just because, in spite of all of that, you have successes and a person can't see you that you're doing bad, doesn't mean that you don't still have pain. So I get, like, someone still is going to have some form of pain that will be with them, but that's not going to stop them. People won't be able to see it because they will have a lot of, successes coming their way. Now, someone very clearly has tried to approach a person, was unsuccessful. They're giving up. They're moving forward. They're moving on. Okay. Second week, I see that there's going to be some news, a decision, messages coming forward about wanting to possibly make amends. There's going to be these attempts throughout the first 2 weeks of June to try and apologize or try to befriend the other person, okay, in this particular relationship, this one-to-one relationship. So if you've been in a bad situation with your mate, you guys will be able to kind of see things through in the by the second week of May, I mean June. But I do see that there's also this individual energy as well. Yeah, because the situation could be quite, I'm just looking, guys. Let's see. The situation is very challenging because I feel that there is a lot of, like, pleasantries and we're going to be nice with each other and we should, and it's the best thing to do, and why are we fighting? But at the same time, there's a lot of hurt feelings and people feel hurt by the other and a lot of resentment about what someone has done to the other person. And you guys are also looking ahead in your relationship separate from each other. So there's this situation of, like, yeah, we're together, but you're making plans independently, right? But you're still playing nice and still, not playing it up for others, but you're kind of just still trying to play nice, and maybe to some extent feeling as though, you don't necessarily want to depart from the relationship, but there's still this idea of, like, I think we're going to find ourselves apart anyway. That's at least how it looks until the second week of June. That's how it appears until the second week of June. Those of you that are single, I see that you may have a lot of suitors, people coming in your midst constantly, just when you're trying to have some time to yourself and try to figure out this thing. You guys have two things on your mind. For damn sure, you cannot figure this out, because one thing you feel is going to be promising, the other thing you feel is going to be a dud. and you just literally don't have the clue, the answer to it. And then someone's coming in and bothering you if you're single. So there's a lot of like people annoyances coming your way. If you've been dating someone, they could have checked out and now you're annoying them. So be careful. If you're out and about socializing with people, you'll see that you're meeting a lot of go-getters, a lot of people that's out and about and doing things. They may talk to you for 2 minutes and 10 minutes and they say, yeah. Oh yeah, I got an hour I could talk. And then after 10 minutes, like, well, listen, it was lovely talking to you. You have a great day. Like that. Like, you are going to be attracting movers and shakers, people that's doing things and all about, you know, the next thing that they have going on. So take it as that, you know, the second week of June, I see that some of you guys will probably hear from someone. I get fire energy. So you may hear from a fire sign who's probably coming back, wants to see you, want to make plans, want to go out, want to kind of get something started as far as like, you know, hey, you want to go here, you want to take a trip, you want to do something. So someone is initiating some movement forward, okay, for you single Libras out there. Some of you Libra men is going to, you know, you're going to have to get on the other side of some pain. Somebody did a Libra man wrong. And until he get on the other side, it's like a process. He has to first get on the other side of it. He's like hell on wheels right now. Then he has to get on the other side of that pain. Then he's going to get even worse as far as like all within himself. It's all within. And eventually he'll be ready to love again and be that committed person. But there's like a huge process that this man is going to go through before he's really ready to say, I'm going to be your husband, the father of your children, and we're going to live the rest of our days together. He'll get there, but it is going to be quite a process. For some Libra men and for some of you Libra women, the male aspect here, it will be a process for him. Now, that's kind of, I want to see what else. For others of you that, you know, there could be a situation where I do see your mate may be working really hard. They're focusing on moving forward and you guys will be going on a trip is what I see. There's going to be a trip that you're going to go on in the second week. Okay. Libra men, all men, for some reason, I usually absolutely almost never, ever, ever get, any messages for men. It's always feminine cards, but men are taking over in June. These men are taking over. And I keep cutting the cards and seeing, so there's going to be somebody, like if you have not been talking to someone, either somebody's going to come out of the blue from your past wanting to talk to you. I'm getting fire sign very strongly. They could have water in their chart. Libra. This is about to get real. This third and fourth week. This thing, because I get it's just like a move, a leave, or a decision of one out of two things you need to decide. And the second week, it'll come. And it'll come by way of either decision that you make, but I get more news. You're going to hear some news, okay? You're going to get some news, and it's almost be like, yay, I can do it. Oh, wow, I could do that? It's like, yeah, do this. And you do it, and bam. And that's when you're going to know that this is your new path forward. This is it. This is where everything else is going to start to fall in place. So second week of June is powerful, but it has nothing on the third and fourth week, to be honest. Like, huge things will be happening the third and fourth week. So that's what I have for you guys for the first 2 weeks of June. If you're interested in the extended, make sure you check the link below and it'll take you right there. If you would like to share with us how this has been helpful or just share your thoughts, please do so in the comment section below. You know, I'd love to hear from you. If you would like something personal with me, I can be reaching the beginning and end to this video. And if you are new to this channel, welcome. And subscribe, because I will be back very soon with another one. Take care, Libra.